Good afternoon. Can I remind members that social distancing measures are in place in the Chamber and across the Holyrood campus, and I ask that members take care to observe these measures, including when entering and exiting the Chamber. And please only use the aisles and walkways to access your seat and when moving around the Chamber. The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Reverend Anna Rodwell, Minister, Kelso North and Ednam Parish Church in the Scottish Borders.
Hello, a little poetry to start us off in your new session today. Breathes there the man with soul so dead, who never to himself hath said, this is my own, my native land. Whose heart has ne'er within him burned, when home his footsteps he hath turned, from wandering on a foreign strand. Okay, who wrote that? It's our other national bard, it's Sir Walter Scott, and I'm a borderer, what do you expect? I'm deeply honoured and excited to be given this chance to facilitate a time for reflection, 4 minutes, where we can raise our thoughts above that which we can see and touch and smell. It's a moment to contemplate the numinous. As a Christian, I have to stand ready to account for the hope that is within me. So when asked to address this esteemed parliament, I thought, what useful can I say to these men and women who hold the fate of this glorious country in their hands? And that's when these words of Sir Walter Scott came to me, because that passion that is present in Scott's words, it's held by so many Scots for this their land of birth or their adopted homeland. It tells of a sense of belonging, a sense of security. But now, at this time, we feel a sense almost of missing peace. And that peace can be spelled either way. There is an angst, a loneliness, a sense of being at sea. What can we do to help? Well, the Church is an organisation that exists to help those out with its membership. It's there to foster community, to show God's love in words and action, to get alongside people and let them know that they are not alone. And if we are created to live in a relationship with God and in fellowship with one another, there will always be something missing until we enter into that fellowship and into that relationship. So speak to the faith communities in your constituencies. You will be welcomed, and I believe you will find a group of people who are willing to respond to human need with loving service. You'll find a group of people who are passionate about creation and about the earth and how to sustain and nurture life on this planet. You will find a group of people who realise that we are only as great as the least of us. And while any suffer, we all suffer. So fix your eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. For what is seen is temporary, and what is unseen is eternal. I wish you all the best for this, your new session. Thank you.